Hey folks, today a new session about my Asia series. Something changed since Friday, because now I'm a MVP. I'm really happy about the graduation from Microsoft, so many thanks to Microsoft, many thanks to my promoters, and I'm really happy to achieve this graduation. So today we talk about a new configuration settings in Azure Active Directory, best practices, so my recommendations to you. So this is a level 100 session, but before we start, I'd like to give you a short introduction about me. My name is Hannes Lagler-Grüner. I'm a multi-cloud architect in one of the biggest consulting company in Austria. I'm since Friday an MVP and Microsoft Asia MVP. I'm working since 2012 with public cloud, with public hyperscaler, mainly focusing on Microsoft Asia. But over the time, I'm realizing it's also a good idea to go more broader. So I'm also specialized into AWS and GCP too. But my main focus is Microsoft Asia. You can find my social profile on Facebook, Twitter, Xing, LinkedIn. I have for sure my private blog called cloudblogger.at and my YouTube channel. If you want to search for my source codes, you can also find my GitHub repos. So I have many source codes, many demo scripts, ARM templates, solutions available on my GitHub channel, so feel free and have a look to my repo. Okay, so enough from me, so let's switch over to my live demo. Today it's a little bit different, so we have no theory session, we switch directly into the live demo, and I want to show you the best practices or some tips and tricks from Microsoft Asia. So hand over, here we are. We are in my demo environment, so you can see I've opened the Asia portal. On the left side, you have a navigation, you have your favorites, you have your main navigation, you have in the middle, you can see your dashboards, and on the right, you have different configuration settings. So let's start. First of all, here is the Asia Cloud Shell. I've created a separate video about Asia Cloud Shell, how you can configure Asia Cloud Shell, and for sure, how you can use the Asia Cloud Shell. The next point here is really interesting, but before we start here in this section, let's go to the settings. So we have here our settings. The settings are changed on the last release. So the view or the usability have been changed in the last release. So when we click here, you can see, first of all, your directories. So where you have, where you're able to switch, in which directory you have the permission to switch. So first of all, we see here my private tenant, my second private tenant, and one tenant of my fire department. And the bottom, you can see from my active subscription, from my active tenant, what kind of subscriptions do you have selected, so you can define a filter. So really cool solutions here. So let's go to the filter options what you have. So we're using now the default filter. We can also define a custom filter. So when you have here, so you have here the ability to select, okay, my subscription ID, I only want to see only one subscription, or you have the ability to filter by a subscription name, for example. You have here the ability to select a subscription name and select, okay, I want to only show my MSDN subscription. So this is also possible. So you can define your own filter. Then you have the appearance section, so you can define what happens with your menu here. I love to select the docked version, but you can also select the flyout. The changes, the difference between those are the following. So when you select the flyout, you have more space for your section, for your configuration area. And when you want to fly in your menu, have on the top here the menu, and you can select your configuration settings. And when you click out from the menu, it's fly back, so you can have more space to work. From my point of view, it's better when I have a docked version, so it depends on each preference. Next, you have the ability to change the temp. So from my point of view, when I'm creating a video, it's the best option to use the Asia temp, but you have also the ability to switch to a different temp, so the blue one, the light one, or many customers from mine using the dark one, but it's not really the best for videos. Okay, you have also the ability to change the contrast, so with more contrast options. So in my case, I'm using the default settings. Then you have the ability to change the startup views. So what you want to see when you open the portal asia.com and log in. Normally the default section here is the home area. The home area is this one here, so we switch over in a few seconds. My settings, my configuration is always a dashboard view, and you have now the ability to select, okay, when I'm logged in, to which directory, to which tenant should I log in. So you have here the ability to select your tenant. This is my default tenant, so it's okay, and you can click here on apply. So let's have a look to the difference between home and dashboards. So I'm click here to the home. So in the home area, you have no ability to change something, so this is fixed. You have on the top the Asia services, the last Asia services which you have used, the recent resources, so the most recent resources from your environment. You can have here a list, and you also have the navigate, the tools, and here useful links. From the dashboard perspective, you can define your own dashboard. So this is the default dashboard. You also have the ability to create a new dashboard, a blank dashboard, or you can use a pre-configured dashboard and upload the configuration. So you have here the ability to select, okay, test dashboard. And you also have the ability to select pre-defined tiles, or you can also add tiles from your resources if you want. Okay, this is the second option what you have. So you click on save. And keep in mind, you have now create a dashboard, your private dashboard, but you have the ability to share this dashboard with your customers, with not with your customers, with your colleagues. So you have here the options to share. And when you open the share button, you have the ability to change the name, for example, to select the subscription where the dashboard should be saved. You can define here, publish the, to the dashboards resource group, then a predefined or pre-configured a resource group will be created with the name dashboard. My recommendation here is use or create your own dashboard, your own resource group with your naming schema. Select here the resource group and click on publish. Then you have to add the user to the access control EM list on the resource group to have the ability to use the dashboard. So you can share your dashboard, you can save it to a resource group, and then you have to add the right permission to the user or to the user group to select the dashboard and use the dashboard. So really cool feature. From my point of view, dashboards are really cool when you want to publish or when you want to share billing informations, monitoring information, security informations like security center with your manager and so on. So really cool stuff, you can use it. Okay, then we have the appearance, we have the startup view. Next, we have the language and region. So normally, when you log in to the Asia portal the first time, Asia use the language settings from your physical device. My recommendation here is always change to English. So it's the better option when you switch to English. And from the regional format, select your regional format. In my case, it's English and German, Austria is the regional format. Then we have the ability to add the contact information if you want, and the sign in and sign out options. So you have the ability here to select an idle timeout when you have to log out after hours or minutes. Override, sign me out when I'm inactive, never, or over a second, selected time. And pop-up notifications, so if something changed in the Asia portal, a new release, you can select here, enable or disable the pop-up information if you want. Okay, that's about the settings area. So now we can select this area, the subscription. When we select the subscription, we switch to the settings area, and inside the settings area to subscription filter settings. Okay, that's great. Then we have here our notification tab or notification area. Every time when you create a resource, when you change a resource, when you remove resources, or when new features are available in the Asia portal, you see this information in the notification area. So when a new change is made in Asia portal, you always see the notification. So when you refresh your portal, you will see the notification too. Keep in mind, when you create a resource and refresh the portal or the browser session, you're not able to see the notification when the refresh is done. So let's show this section here. This option. So let's go to a resource group, for example, the billing app, and add here a new resource named Network Security Group. Here we are, Network Security Group, create a new one, fill out the requirements, MSG test 01, select the region, click on create and review, click on create, but nothing changed in this not favorite section here. So what does this mean is you have here your marketplace, and we can select here, see more in marketplace. And here you have the ability to see your favorites from your marketplace. So in this case, I'm add the network security groups to my favorite inside my marketplace. I can also remove this section here. So when we want to add, or when we want to pin something to our favorite section here, go to the all services, select network security groups. Here we are. Select the network security group, but don't click on the network security group. And on the right side, you have here a star. And when you select the star and it's selected now, you can see here, okay, I've now pinned the network security group out to my dashboard area. I can change the section here to upper or to lower. And I also have the ability to remove the network security group when I select the star once more. Okay, that's it. That's from my tips and tricks from the portal perspective. So keep in mind, the changes or the settings which I've present now changed, maybe in the next release from the Asia portal. So let's have a look. Change the default settings, change the language settings, a highly recommended part from my side. Always switch to English and select the right region format from your location. Change your dashboard, change your favorites, what you prefer. Have fun with Azure Cloud. Have fun with the ability, with the power of the Microsoft Azure Cloud. And I will see you soon in my next video. Goodbye.